Tim Bauerschmidt.
Hey, nice to meet you, Tim. And
I'm Ramey.
Ramey, nice to meet you, Ramey.
Thank you.
Take that over to the elevator, ride it up, and then we'll drive to the next stop. How's that? That works?
Pretty soon you'll be driving that thing.
I'll tell you something, there's a lot of these tailors wish they could go up and down the elevator. I bet you there's a lot of people right now they're going to be just tagging along.
That's it.
Okay? So we're on your timeline now, so you just take...
We've shot 200 dead loads between the four catapults right now, right at about 200. We've essentially tested the cats fully. We have one more small test to do. All right, so.
Sitting up there, you know.
Where's you got, your office?
So my office, if you were to count, so you see those two like small areas where the windows are over on this side.
Uh-huh.
So you go all the way up one, and you see the first full area where the windows are. That's the pilot house. That's the bridge. That's my office. What works is aircraft will come in overhead at 800 feet. Okay. The Air Boston is in control of the aircraft when they're overhead the ship. Right. So they come in, they'll brake, and they'll turn down all over here. The wind to come perspective of distance. See that little thing, that yellow box right there?
Yeah.
The yellow, and just in front of it, you see that little stanchion that's sticking
yes.
out? Okay, that's called a barricade stanchion. Right? And when you drive back down there, the barricade is basically, think of it as a big net.
All of it.
How about the elevator ride, Mom?
That was great.
What has your journey been like from all over the places you've been? What has it been like to be a part of something like this?
I don't know. It's just mind-boggling. I started out back home and went to all the western states. And then we went all the way around through Florida and up.
What would your word of advice be for living life? You're really living life to the fullest.
Right. Do what you want. The doctors aren't always right.
What has it been like to have your son and your daughter-in-law along with you on this journey?
Oh, this was great. I've never seen them much during the summer, usually about a week or two, and they'd be off again. Now I got them with me, or I'm with them, I should say.
Anything you can say about the shipbuilders here that build these ships? Can you imagine what goes into building something like this?
No, that's why I say it's so amazing. I've never seen anything like this before. Great, very great.
Come on, Jeremy. Say something. Anything? Know anything?
Yeah, I got it. Come on. So I want to learn a little bit about you. Hi, I'm Ryan. I'm with the ship's media department.
Right.
So your time in Waves, how long were you exactly in the program?
In the Waves?
In Waves.
Oh, I don't know. A little over a year or so, a year and a half, something like that.
Seem to be on this incredible journey, traveling the country and everything. What brought you here today is, one, your time in Waves, and one, your unique connection with our namesake, President Ford. How exactly did you meet him?
Well, this was a long time ago, back in 1949. We were just out of, my husband and I were both just out of the service. He was in Army Air Corps. And then we were going to go to school. So we had to go up to Grand Rapids. And our checks from the government didn't follow after no from Toledo, Ohio, and then up to Grand Rapids. And we were down to our last 3 cents. So I told my husband, I said, I'm going to write to Mr. Ford and see if he can help us. He was the new congressman from Michigan. And so that's what I did. And he came out and presented us with our checks. Just like that.
What do you think? So all those years ago today, he was bringing you this check. Do you ever think at any point that you'd be coming aboard an aircraft carrier?
No, no way. Nothing like this at all.
How is this whole experience for you? How would you describe it?
Exciting, for one thing. And I don't know. I just can't express it any other way.
Anything else about life? You can give us any tips on life and enjoying life to the full. Anything you can say. We need wisdom here.
Hey, I'm not so wise. Do what you want. Do what you think feels right for you. That's about it.
What's been your most memorable experience?
Oh, I knew you was going to ask me that. I don't know. This, I think.
This probably tops them all, huh?
Yes. This is it.
We've got a lot of stuff.
Yeah, I don't think we'd get much better than this.
What'd you think of the sailors on board?
Oh, they were great. Very good.
Are they as good looking as they were in World War II?
What made you come to your decision to not do the chemo treatments and to just go with it and enjoy life as much as you can?
I couldn't see me doing that. And no guarantee I'd be any better. Probably worse off than I was to start. So I said no.
How do you feel now? How much do you think this trip has done for your mind, body, and soul?
I think a lot. Because I think this was all a good experience. I enjoyed it very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Any last comments, ma'am? Anything you'd like to add?
Just say thanks, Mom.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank y'all very much. Let me get that microphone from you real quick. Now, shake your hand.